Dear students, आज असी motion of projectile ते अपनी understanding revise करांगे अते फिर ऐसे ते based numerical problems solve करांगे। आज दे इस पाठ विच तुहाडा सारयां दा स्वागत है। आओ पहला horizontal नाल एक angle ते fired projectile देखिए।
Here you are observing a cannon with its barrel at angle theta with respect to the horizontal. When we fire a ball from the cannon, the ball follows a trajectory which is parabolic in shape.
When a cannon fire a ball with initial velocity u and make an angle theta with respect to the horizontal, the velocity of projection of the projectile can be resolved into the following two components as horizontal component ux equal to u cos theta along ox and the vertical component uy equal to u sin theta along oy. Jadon ek projectile move kardi hai, A velocity de horizontal component de karan horizontal distance cover kardi hai. Ate velocity de vertical component de karan vertical distance cover kardi hai. On neglecting air resistance, when the object is thrown with some angle with respect to the horizontal, then the velocity of the projectile along the horizontal remain constant. This means acceleration along x-axis, ax, remains zero, whereas the velocity along the vertical goes on decreasing due to the effect of gravity. And the acceleration along the vertical, ay, is equal to minus g. The position of the projectile at any time t along the x-axis is given by x equal to uxt plus half of ax into t square. On substituting the values of ux, ax and x, the equation becomes x equal to u cos theta t plus half 0 into t square, that is x is equal to u cos theta t. Similarly, the position of the projectile at any time t along the y-axis is given by y equal to uyt plus half of ay into t square. On substituting the values of uy, ay and y, the equation becomes y equal to u sin theta t minus half into g into t square. By eliminating t, we get the equation of the projectile path as y equal to x tan theta minus g by 2u square cos square theta into x square. S relation to asi total time of flight t kad sakte ha. This is the time during which the object remains in air. Kyunki origin point to highest point tak ate highest point to end point tak ta motion symmetrical honda hai. Is karke time of ascent ate time of descent barabar honda hai, which is equal to t by 2. With the help of first equation of motion along y axis, we get t is equal to 2u sin theta by g. Projectile dwara maximum height gained da pata karan le, asi second equation of motion along y axis use karde ha. We get maximum height h equal to u square sin square theta upon 2g. We know that motion along x axis is uniform motion. Therefore, distance covered by the projectile along x-axis, that is, horizontal range, r, is simply the product of velocity ux and the time of flight t. By substituting the corresponding values, we get horizontal range r equal to u square sine 2 theta upon g. Results pertaining to a projectile's motion are strictly valid if the air resistance is negligible. The flight is over a limited altitude, so that the variation of g with the altitude is negligible, and the range is small enough so that the curvature of the earth may be ignored. Furthermore, when a projectile leaving in the horizontal direction with initial velocity u at a height h above the ground, then h is equal to half gt square. Therefore, time of flight t is equal to under root 2h upon g. Whereas the horizontal range r is equal to u into under root 2h upon g. The resultant of striking velocity v is square root of u square plus 2gh, and the angle with which it strikes the ground with respect to negative x-axis, that is theta, is tan inverse of square root of 2gh upon u. Let us try an interesting problem.
Let a hunter direct his rifle towards a monkey sitting on a tree at a height h above the ground and at distance d. The instant the monkey observes the flash of the fire of the rifle, it drops from the tree. The question is, will the bullet hit the monkey? Let the rifle be fixed at A and point in the direction AB at an angle alpha with the horizontal, with muzzle speed u. Let point A be the origin. Resolving the velocity along the horizontal direction and vertical direction, that is, ux as u cos alpha and uy as u sin alpha. As gravitational force is perpendicular to ux, the x component remains constant. Let the bullet reach the point D, vertically below the point B, in time t. Then D would be ux into t, which is ut cos alpha. The vertical component of velocity reduces due to its motion against acceleration due to gravity. In the same time, let the monkey reach at height h from the ground. Then, for the motion along vertical, h would be equal to uy into t minus half gt square, which is ut sin alpha minus half gt square. By substituting the value of t in the first part of the equation, we get h is equal to d tan alpha minus half g into t square. Since d tan alpha is equal to small h, therefore small h minus capital H becomes half gt square.
But the quantity small h minus capital H represents the height through which the monkey drops from the tree due to free fall in the same time t. Therefore, the bullet would hit the monkey. Ek significant fact a hai ki horizontal ate vertical motions ek duje ton independent hunde han. Jedi force bullet ate monkey ਦੋਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੀਆਂ ਰਿਸਪੈਕਟਿਵ ਹਾਈਟਸ ਲੂਜ਼ ਕਰਨ ਲਈ ਮਜਬੂਰ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਹੈ ਗ੍ਰੈਵੀਟੇਸ਼ਨਲ ਫੋਰਸ। ਇਸੇ ਦੇ ਕਾਰਨ ਬੁਲੇਟ ਸਿੱਧਾ ਸਟ੍ਰੇਟ ਲਾਈਨ ਏ ਬੀ 'ਤੇ ਤੁਰਨ ਦੀ ਥਾਂ ਪੈਰਾਬੋਲਿਕ ਪਾਥ ਏ ਡੀ 'ਤੇ ਤੁਰਦੀ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਆਲਟੀਟਿਊਡ ਬੀ ਡੀ ਲੂਜ਼ ਕਰ ਦਿੰਦੀ ਹੈ। ਮੌਂਕੀ ਵੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਫ੍ਰੀ ਫਾਲ ਦੌਰਾਨ ਇਹੀ ਆਲਟੀਟਿਊਡ ਲੂਜ਼ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ। ਇੱਥੋਂ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਹੋਰੀਜ਼ੋਂਟਲੀ ਫਾਇਰਡ ਬੁਲੇਟ ਰੇਟ ਆਫ ਇਟਸ ਫਾਲ ਨੂੰ ਇਨਫਲੂਐਂਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦੀ। ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਬੁਲੇਟ ਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਮਰਜ਼ੀ ਵੈਲੋਸਿਟੀ ਨਾਲ ਫਾਇਰ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾਵੇ ਉਹ ਮੌਂਕੀ ਨੂੰ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਅਤੇ ਜ਼ਰੂਰ ਹਿੱਟ ਕਰੇਗੀ। ਦਸ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਇਜ਼ ਗ੍ਰੇਟਰ ਦੈਨ ਟੀ ਵੁੱਡ ਬੀ ਲੈਸ। ਫੋਰ ਮੋਰ ਕਲੈਰਿਟੀ ਲੈਟ ਅਸ ਟਰਾਈ ਸਮ ਮੋਰ ਨਿਊਮੈਰੀਕਲ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮਸ।
ਵਾਟ ਵੁੱਡ ਬੀ ਮੈਕਸੀਮਮ ਰੇਂਜ ਐਜ ਵੈਲ ਐਜ ਐਂਗਲ ਆਫ ਪ੍ਰੋਜੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਅ ਪ੍ਰੋਜੈਕਟਾਈਲ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰੋਜੈਕਟਿਡ ਵਿਦ ਵੈਲੋਸਿਟੀ 49 meters per second. For maximum range, the angle of projection would be 45 degrees, at which the value of sine 2 theta would be maximum, that is 1. Therefore, the maximum horizontal range would be u square upon g, that is 49 square upon 9.8 or 245 meters. In our next problem, let a projectile be projected with a velocity of 98 meters per second and the horizontal distance covered by it is 490 meters. Then find out the angle of projection. For angle of projection theta, the horizontal range is given by r equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. On substituting the values of u, g and r, we get sine 2 theta equal to r into g by u square or 490 into 9.8 by 98 square, that is 0.5. Therefore, 2 theta would be either 60 degrees or 120 degrees. That is, theta would be either 30 degrees or 60 degrees. In the same problem, find out the time of flight. In this problem, we know the velocity of projection is 98 meters per second. But here we have two angles of projection, which is either 30 degrees or 60 degrees. On substituting the values of u, g and theta in relation for time of flight, that is 2u sine theta by g, we get t equal to either 2 into 98 into sine 30 degrees by 9.8 or 2 into 98 into sine 60 degrees by 9.8. This gives t equal to either 10 seconds or 17.3 seconds. In our next problem, a projectile is projected at an angle theta. Horizontal range and maximum height described by the projectile are 49 meters and 19.6 meters respectively. You have to find out the velocity of projection. We know that the horizontal range r is equal to u square sine 2 theta upon g, which is equal to 49 meters. And the maximum height h is equal to u square sine square theta upon g, which is equal to 19.6 meter. The ratio of r and h is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g upon u square sine square theta by g, which is equal to 2u square sine theta into cos theta by g upon u square sine theta into sine theta upon g, equal to 49/19.6. This gives 2 cot theta equal to 2.5, or cot theta is equal to 1.25. Therefore, angle theta is 38.66 degree. From the relation of maximum height, we get u square sine square theta equal to 19.6 into g. For theta equal to 38.66 degree, value of sine theta is 0.6248. On substituting the value of theta in the relation, we get u square equal to 19.6 into 9.8 divided by square of 0.6248, or u square is equal to 492.04. This gives velocity of projectile u is 22.18 meter per second. The next problem is, a cricketer can throw a ball to a maximum horizontal distance of 196 meter. How much high above the ground can cricketer throw the same ball? We know the formula of maximum horizontal range is u square by g. Here, the maximum horizontal range is r maximum equal to 196 meter. Therefore, 196 is equal to u square by g, or u is equal to 19.6 under root 5 meter per second. For vertical motion, initial velocity u is equal to 19.6 under root 5 meter per second. Final velocity is 0, and acceleration a is minus 9.8 meter per second square. Now, using the relation v square equal to u square plus 2ah, and on substituting the values, we get h equal to 98 meter. In our next problem, a boy playing on the roof of a 20 meter high building throws a ball with a speed of 19.6 meter per second at an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal. How far from the throwing point will the ball be at the height of 20 meter from the ground? Here, g is given as 9.8 meter per second square. Since the boy playing on the roof of a 20 meter high building throws the ball with a speed of 19.6 meter per second at an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal. Here, h is 20 meter, u is equal to 19.6 meter per second, theta is equal to 60 degree, and g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. When the ball is at a height of 20 meter from the ground, the throwing point and the end point are at same height. Therefore, distance between these two positions would be equal to horizontal range. Horizontal range is given as r equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. On substituting the values of u, theta and g, we get r equal to 19.6 square into sine 120 degree upon 9.8, which is equal to 39.2 into root 3 upon 2 or 19.6 root 3 meter. On further simplification, we get the range as 33.95 meter. Let us see another problem. A packet is dropped from an aircraft traveling horizontally at 120 meter per second at a height of 490 meter. Find A. the time taken to reach the ground, B. the horizontal distance traveled before hitting the ground, and C. the magnitude and direction of its velocity as it strikes the ground. This is a special case of a projectile leaving the horizontal direction with initial velocity u at a height h above the ground, where u is 120 meter per second and h is 490 meter. In this case, angle of projection is 0 degree. Vertical component of initial velocity uy is also 0 and horizontal component ux is u. Here h is equal to half gt square. Therefore, t is equal to under root 2h upon g. In the given example, t would be square root of 2 into 490 upon 9.8, that is 10 seconds. Whereas horizontal range r is equal to ut or u into under root 2h upon g. Hence, in this example, r would be 120 into 10, that is 1200 meter. When the packet hit the ground, vertical component of its striking velocity, Vy, would be under root 2gh and the horizontal component Vx would be u. Hence, the resultant of striking velocity V would be under root of Vx square plus Vy square, which is under root of u square plus 2gh. And if theta be the angle with which it strikes the ground with respect to negative x-axis, then tan theta is equal to Vy upon Vx, that is under root 2gh upon u. Therefore, in the given example, striking velocity V would be under root of 120 square plus 2 into 9.8 into 490, which is equal to under root 24,004 or 154.9 meter per second. And the angle with which it strikes the ground, theta, is equal to tan inverse of under root 2gh upon u, which is equal to tan inverse of under root 2 into 9.8 into 490 upon 120. Therefore, theta is equal to 39.23 degree. In another problem, a cricketer can throw a ball to a maximum horizontal distance of 100 meter. How much high above ground can cricketer throw the same ball? For finding the solution, we have to use the formula of maximum horizontal range. Here, the maximum horizontal range is R maximum, which is equal to 100 meter. Since the maximum horizontal range is R maximum equal to u square by g, then on substituting the value of R maximum, we get 100 is equal to u square by g. On simplification, we get u is equal to under root 100 g meter per second, which is equal to under root 100 into 9.8, that is 14 root 5 meter per second. For vertical motion, initial velocity u is equal to under root 100 g meter per second. Final velocity is 0 and acceleration a is equal to minus g. Now, using the relation v square minus u square equal to 2ah, where h is the maximum height achieved, and substituting the values for u, v and a, we get 0 square minus square of under root 100 g equal to 2 into minus g into h. Simplifying, we get h equal to 100 g upon 2 g, which is equal to 50 meter. Here, the cricketer can throw the same ball 50 meter above the ground. In another problem, a boy playing football, when hit the ball with a speed of 29.4 meter per second, just passes over a pole of height 4.9 meter. What would be the range of the ball? In this problem, u is given as 29.4 meter per second and maximum height h as 4.9 meter. Since the maximum height attained by the projectile h is equal to u square sin square theta upon 2g, or sin square theta is equal to 2hg upon u square. On substituting the values of h, u and g, we can find out the angle of projection theta. Here, sin square theta is equal to 2 into 4.9 into 9.8 upon 29.4 square. This gives 9.8 upon 29.4 whole square. Hence, sin theta is equal to 9.8 upon 29.4 or 1 by 3. Therefore, the range r can be measured as 2u square sin theta into cos theta upon g, that is 2 into square of 29.4 upon 9.8 into 1 by 3 into 2 root 2 by 3, which is 55.4 meter. In yet another problem, an object is thrown into the air at 30 degree with the horizontal on a level ground with speed of 19.6 meter per second. What are the vertical and horizontal components of the initial velocity? What is the maximum height reached? The vertical component of the velocity is u sin 30 degree, which would be equal to 9.8 meter per second. And the horizontal component of the velocity is u cos 30 degree, which would be equal to 16.97 meter per second. The maximum height is u square sin square 30 by 2g, which would be 4.9 meter.
So now we come to the end of today's topic. Here is a quick test for you to find out how much have you actually absorbed. The first question is, give the relation for horizontal range. The answer is, horizontal range r is equal to u square sin 2 theta upon g. The next question is, give the relation for maximum height. The answer is, maximum height attained by the projectile h is equal to u square sin square theta upon 2g. मैनू तुहाडे ते पूरा भरोसा है कि तुसीं इन्हां सारिआं प्रश्नां दे उत्तर समझ सके होवोगे। आस है कि तुसीं अज दे पाठ विच दसे क्वेश्चन्स तों बिना इस तत्थ नाल संबंधित होर भी क्वेश्चन्स आप ही सॉल्व कर सकोगे। पाठ ते ध्यान देण लई धन्नवाद। सी यू नेक्स्ट टाइम एंड ऑल द बेस्ट अंटिल देन।